Welcome to my channel. So today I wanted to talk about another TV show which you probably haven't heard about, but it's absolutely amazing, so I really wanted to share it with you guys. So I know it's another TV show video, but that's what I feel like talking at the moment. I have read also a lot of books. If you want to read about books, you can check out my blog, which I will link in the description. In the meantime, I really want to talk about this show. It's actually a German miniseries with 3 episodes of about 1.5 hours. And apparently they're gonna make a second season in September, and I'm really excited about it. The show is called Kudamm 56 or Berlin 56, and it depends. In Germany it's called Kudamm 56, and it's sometimes translated as Berlin 56 because it takes place in 1956, and Kudamm is one of the famous Berlin streets, but it may not be known as South Germany, which is why it's also sometimes called Berlin 56. Anyway, as you probably know, I live in Berlin this year, which is why I was really glad to find this show. Actually, a friend recommended it to me, and I eventually decided to check it out, and oh my god, I so do not regret this decision. It's absolutely amazing. So the show takes place after the Second World War, when Berlin is divided. It's in 1956, so the wall hasn't been built yet, but you can still already feel the difference building up between the East and the West. So Kurfürstendamm, which is the name of the street, is set in the West, West Berlin. I think it's in the British sector. I'm not entirely sure, I don't want to give you wrong ideas. If you want to know, you can probably check it out. Basically, it's a huge street which is sometimes compared to Paris Champs-Élysées, which in my opinion is a very wrong comparison, but that's not the subject of this video. It's basically a very, very long and large street with huge buildings and shops and everything. And the main story is centered on this dance school, which is directed by a woman who has 3 daughters, and they leave the 4 of them together because the father didn't return after war. Basically, it's about this woman who wants what's best for her 3 daughters and who wants them to get married. One of the girls is getting married actually at the very beginning of the series, and her mother-in-law, right before the wedding, tells her that getting married to this man is gonna be very hard. And she's like, yeah, I love him, it's not gonna be a problem. And very soon we find out what she was referring about, and I thought it was very, very interesting to read about this. I mean, historically this was very interesting. I don't want to tell you more about it because it's an important part of the plot and I don't want to spoil it for you, but that's it for the second daughter. The first daughter, I mean, I'm sorry. The second daughter is working as a nurse, which is a bit of a reminder of the war that took place only 11 years before. I mean, that ended only 11 years before. And her mother wants her to marry her boss, who's a doctor, and at first she is of course agreeing with this because he's very rich and she wants to have an important social status, but things evolve. She's working actually in a hospital dealing with patient with mental illness, and you see the horrible way they were treated at that time. It's really, really powerful to see that. I mean, there are a few very powerful scenes and troubling, and she has to think about this, and little by little she meets another guy and she might be falling in love with him, which is trouble because she's supposed to marry this boss of hers who's old and rich, and I believe used to work with the Nazis. This whole idea of the Nazis is also very important in the show because the story takes place only soon after the war, and actually this kind of witch hunt after the Nazis and the people who were powerful during the Nazi regime is something that wasn't very active at this time because it had to wait. And there you can notice in the show that a lot of important people used to be Nazis or part of the Nazi regime, and it's very interesting to see that. I mean, of course, it's horrible to imagine that these people were part of the Nazi regime. But at the same time, it's also a very, very interesting view on the society and on homosexuality and progress and everything. And the last girl, who is my favorite and the main character, has just been sent back home from the school she was attending, where she was, I believe, learning how to be a good lady or something, which I didn't really catch everything because I watched the show in German and my German is quite terrible, so I didn't understand exactly everything. But apparently, she was sent home from the school because she was dancing outside and it was considered not ladylike, and she was sent home. But the thing is, she really likes dancing. Her mother has a dancing school, as I mentioned before, but she really likes rock and roll. And on the way home from the school, she tries to commit suicide. But she's saved by this young man called Freddy, who was carrying a guitar, I believe, or some kind of musical instrument, I can't remember. But what matters is that at her sister's wedding, he's the one in charge of the music, so they meet again. And they get to know each other. He's a really interesting person and he loves dancing as well. And he teaches her how to dance rock and roll. But of course, her mother can't know about this because she disapproves. And her mother wants her to marry this young man called Joachim Frank, who is the son of a very wealthy man but is also a very unpleasant person. In my opinion, at least at first, even if it grew on me a little bit, even if it was very troubling. I mean, I don't want to spoil you, but he's this very unpleasant person and she doesn't like him anyway. And her mother doesn't care that he's a bad person who likes sleeping around and whatever because he's rich and she wants her daughters to marry rich. Yeah, that's about it for the three daughters. And basically, this show is about Berlin in the 50s and about rock and roll and the way society is evolving, and it's absolutely incredible. If you like history, if you are curious about Berlin, it's something that could be really a kind of eye-opener, and I definitely recommend it. I personally can't wait for the next season because I really like those characters. I really like the way the series ended and I can't wait to know what happened next. So, yeah. If you watched this series, let me know what you thought of it in the comments. If you want to watch, also let me know because I would be really glad if you did. And yeah, I guess that's it for these videos. Thank you so much for watching. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it, please, and maybe subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of my videos. And I guess I'll see you around. Bye!